You live in there. You live there, right?
Yeah.
Stay there. How many years you been in that home?
Oh, I've been there for about 20 years.
Stay another 20. It's a nice neighborhood.
I would, Claude, but I found a new home to move to, and I don't really want to pay two mortgages when I don't have to, and
makes a lot of sense. Makes a lot of sense. Okay, time out. What did I just do? Did you hear? There's something I haven't taught you yet, but you might have read it or saw the video. Do you know what I just did? Let's see how.
What do you call it? Negative redirection? Is that it?
Very good. Excellent. No, that was great. That was great. That's a redirection. I got that from law school. I'm a recovering attorney. One of the most important things you can do is go in the totally unexpected direction. Why? Why is that so psychologically? Why is that so powerful? What did that force you to do?
The prospect, such as like myself, would have the feeling, the need to want to correct you. So you want to, it's like helping grandma at the airport with the bags. Is that correct?
Yeah, yeah.
You heard that one?
Oh, I can't, you know, yeah. That was kind of more of a guilt about moms, you know, how our mothers affect us. I'm a Freudian. I believe a lot in Freud. I think certain aspects of Freud were very, Oedipus. You know, I was very close to my mother, and she had a very strong influence on me in many different ways. And one of them is that guilt shit. I don't know about your mom, but my mom, she raised me on guilt.
Let me guess, don't talk to strangers.
Don't talk to strangers. I raised you better than that. You see an old person, you hold the door open for them. You say please and thank you. And an old lady in the airport says she needs help and I'm late for a plane. I can't help you, grandma. Yeah, I'm going to be late. I had to turn around and help her. I had no control of my body because of what mom put in my head. So that's a little bit different than what you're thinking, but that's what happens from our environment, from our parents, what we derive from them. Do you ever do something because, well, that's what mom raised. That's how mom raised me. That's how I was raised.
Yeah. Either how we were raised or something we saw personally on.
Yeah. I remember, and that's the way you raise your children. I remember once my son, little guy, and he bumped into a lady in the supermarket and he said nothing. And I stopped, I turned around, I said, you're going to apologize to that lady. And we walked all the way back down the aisle. And I said, excuse me, I'm sorry, I bumped into you. He never did that again. I mean, my wife just said, you're mean. You know what? He's a great kid today. He's got first class manners. And I think good manners and being respectful to people is important in life. Maybe that's just me.
Yeah.
I'm old school like that.
Same here.
Yeah. Good for you. There's nothing wrong with having character. So I did a redirection.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, and redirection can come before the agenda or during the agenda or after the agenda. You might want to go to them. You might want to go to somebody. Well, gee, you know, the doc, what did we do with the doctor? And you were my doctor and I walked in. What was the first thing you said to me?
Hey, Claude, what brings you in today?
Yeah. So if somebody has an ad on Zoom, mm-hmm. buying, selling, investing, there's an MLS listing, there's a sign. Now I can hear background noise.
Sorry, that was just a motorcycle that just
drove. Oh, okay. something in Craigslist. Someone gives you a lead. You do some attraction marketing. You get a lead from some source. And you get that person on the phone. I'm texting and email and virtual assistants are fine, but I like to talk with people. Okay. So the first thing I do is, hey, what's the problem? Albert, what's the problem? Why are we talking today? If I could help you solve this problem, are you ready to move forward are you ready to make a decision today? Are you the person in charge? What's the issue? Why are we speaking today? What would you like from me? Okay, I just gave you 8, 9, 10 different ways to get the other person talking. See, we work too hard. We think we got to go yak, yak, yak and give a presentation. All I have to do is be the psychiatrist, right? You're on my couch. You're laying down. Hey, Albert, what? You're having trouble sleeping or something like that? Tell me about it.
Yeah, you know, I put my head on the pillow and close my eyes, try to count sheep, try to count down from 1,000.
How's that affecting you? How does that feel physically? That's not a strain, is it? Or
just wake up tired, or no.
Tired all the time.
I can't sleep.
Oh, I can't imagine how uncomfortable. You're always a little bit tired, right?
Yep.
Okay. Off the role play. Did you hear the negative redirection? I'm recording this for you.
Yeah.
Did you hear the negative redirection?
It might have just kind of went over me.
I do it so stealthily, so subtly that you don't hear it. So you have to, that's why I record these things. I do these moves combined with a little theater. And what I said to you is, that's not affecting you in any way, is it?
Oh, okay. Now I got it.
And you immediately, so I went left, you went right. I went up, you went down. I went negative, I went positive. That's not affecting you, right? Oh, yeah, it is. Boom. Pendulum. You ever see a grandfather clock with a pendulum or those little balls?
Yeah.
Those click clack balls. You know, when the one on the right goes all the way down, it sets off the one on the left, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's called positive and negative redirection.
Yeah.
It's one of the most dangerous things I teach. Because what does it force you to do?
Answer a question without thinking twice about it.
Right. So the answer to your question earlier is all you have to do is go ask a question with a negative or a positive nuance. Hey, go ahead. Ask me, why should I work with maybe? Why should I work with you? You know, something like that. Let me demonstrate another redirection here. Go ahead. Why should I work with you?
Is that what you want me to ask you?
Yeah.
Well, why should I work with you?
Maybe you shouldn't.
Well, you say so.
Yeah, I mean, you called me. We're having this meeting. You seem like a nice fella and everything. I don't know why you should work with me. Maybe you shouldn't. I mean, what's really the issue here? What's really the problem? Can you help me out a little bit? I'm not sure if I understand why we are talking.
I just kind of want to have a sense of how to, I guess, sort of steer a conversation with a homeowner
That isn't a problem, is it?
Kind of is, actually.
You don't think it's affecting your income, do you?
Oh, it definitely is.
How about your comfort level, your happiness? You know, it's nice to be happy. Do you feel you're in sales? You don't think this could be affecting how you feel about yourself, your security, your confidence, your general happiness and well-being? That's not something that it's being affected, is it?
Definitely is.
Now, most people will not see what I'm doing while I'm doing that.
That's why it's so dangerous.
It's why it's so dangerous. And nobody teaches this. My superstar students, people who are making a lot of money, understand that people make decisions emotionally. You've got to learn to ask questions. You've got to use the three-step system, agenda, qualification, close, by asking questions, with stroking, nurturing, and empathy. And the nuance is to go in the opposite redirection or the redirection. Okay. So that they give everything to you on a silver platter. See, when I say, well, get a realtor, you know, it can't be that bad, right? No, it is bad. I bought another house. I don't need two payments. I'm moving in 2 weeks. My wife can't sleep at night because we're worried about the double payment. We haven't been able to sell this house in 6 weeks. Boom. What did you just give me on a silver platter?
all the information you need.
Exactly. So the answer to your question is that you have to use redirection or ask the obvious, you know, hey, Albert, I want to know more about you. I've got a few ideas or solutions for you. I've heard this problem before, and I'm really glad we're talking. Could I ask you 2-3 questions? You ask me 2 or 3. I'll make you an offer, and if we can do business, great. If not, we're still friends, and you can fire me. Is that fair?
That sounds fair.
Okay. Why are we talking today? You're trying to buy a home, sell a home, invest in a home, start a new business. What are you looking to do?
Trying to purchase a home.
Oh, okay. What's the big deal? Just go to a realtor, go to a bank, get a mortgage, and buy the home, right? I'm not sure if I understand the problem.
Well, I was hoping I can use some creative financing to acquire the home. I'm an investor.
Right.
I've been hearing all these things about real estate investing, and, you know, I've been bit by the real estate bug, so I kind of want to increase my income and get some financial freedom and, you know, take control of essentially my financial future. So that's why I'm here.
Good for you. I appreciate that. I've been in real estate a while. I love real estate. I'm in my home in California. I own homes in many other places and land. And I really enjoy real estate. It's given me great freedom and everything. So I didn't quite understand. Why don't you just call a realtor and just put some money down and buy the home? What am I missing here exactly?
Well, this is my first time purchasing any kind of property. So I'd like to know some of the lingo and the meaning of it. I don't know. Because again, this is my first time getting a property. So I kind of don't want to go into it unprepared, in a sense.
Good for you. You know, it takes a wise man to know his own shortcomings. Jack Nicholson said in one movie, what was it? Midnight Cowboy. Was it Midnight Cowboy? The motorcycle one? What was that?
I'm only familiar with a few Jack Nicholson movies.
I love Jack Nicholson. And he said, a man's got to know his limitations. Easy Rider. 1968, Easy Rider. And he said, and he's in jail with Peter Fonda. And he says, you know, a man's got to know his limitations. And good for you for knowing your limitations. I'm here to help. So if you found somebody, maybe me, maybe somebody else who could help you step by step for a very reasonable fee to help you to get to do the deals and do them legally in the right way and protect yourself and make money. You wouldn't make that isn't something you could make a decision on right away, is it?
Another negative redirect? Yes.
Yes. Off the role play, you can go negative or positive to get the answer and the information you want. Okay. And redirect, see, GUTS is a question-based system. You learn to ask questions the right way. And something as simple, or you might, I'm doing, I'm glad I'm recording these for you. A simple, I might do also something. We talked a little bit about pattern interrupts. Have you watched that video yet?
Is that after the commitment close? Because I didn't go
to that. A pattern interrupt is when you're calling somebody up, maybe it's a cold call. Okay, there's a difference between cold calls and warm calls. A warm call is like a follow-up call, or someone told you to get back to them, or they called you. A cold call is when you're just coming out of nowhere.
Yeah, right.
And so you will use pattern interrupts, which are a pattern interrupt is to interrupt the normal response pattern of the prospect. So you might say something like, ring, ring.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi. Is this Albert? Is this Albert?
That's correct.
Who Albert, I owe you an apology. Claude Diamond here. I think I've had your post-it with your phone number on my desk for 3 weeks. Is this about real estate?
I believe it is. How did you get my number?
I don't know. Did you ever have a number? It says Albert and your phone number here. And I'm not really sure. Maybe you called me and left a message.
Honestly, I'm not sure.
Well, maybe you went to my way. Oh, I bet you went to. Do you watch? Do you ever go on YouTube? You don't go on YouTube, do you?
Yeah, I do. I use YouTube all the time.
I have 1,300 videos on YouTube. I bet you saw one of my videos on YouTube and you called me. I bet that was it.
That probably might be it.
That was it. So what are we talking about today? Could you just help me? If it's about real estate, I love helping people solve problems. What are we talking about today? What did I just do? Off the role play.
I guess that was the pattern interrupt, right?
Sure was. Did I act confused?
Yeah, you were confused, yeah. You want to know why we're talking? And I think you helped me to help you provide how you got my name and number. Something like that, right?
Right. No, you got it. You're right on target, man. And that's when you show vulnerability. Could you help me? I've got your name and number here. I'm not sure why I'm calling. And then I gave you a few answers. You might be even a cold call. But if I'm calling you like I'm getting back and then I'm asking for help, can you help me? The old lady in the airport, can you help me with my bag?
Yeah.
Somebody comes up to you and says, gee, do you know, I'm looking for the thrifty ice cream store. Do you know where that is? I can't find it. Do you know where that is?
Yeah, it's a couple streets down this way and that way.
Make it left and right. Thank you so much. I went so low. I get lost on a thick carpet. Thank you so much. Okay, boom. Cool. You see what I'm doing. So sometimes you use pattern interrupts. Sometimes you use redirection or familiarity. Or sometimes you use vulnerability. But it's always question-based.
Open-ended, right?
Can be closed-ended. Mostly open-ended. Why? Good point. Really good point.
So the prospect speaks more and we get more information from them that way.
Exactly. So everything I just taught you the last 30 minutes. No, it wasn't that long. I don't think we've been on that long. Your original question was.
Where do we go from after the agenda?
Right. We because enter. Go ahead.
I feel like. I don't know if I'm just doing this to myself, but. I was just thinking that homeowners will start saying things, like I said, the lingo about, you know, real estate lingo, and I won't be able to really understand it fully. And if I ask them what something means, they're probably thinking, why would you not know?
I don't, you know,
I even trust doing business with you. You know what I mean?
They may do that. They may attack. Go ahead. Attack me. Go ahead. Watch how I defend myself. Watch how I regain control.
Claude, how do you not know what the meaning of paying down a mortgage is, for example?
I just didn't know what you meant by it, sir. You mean paying? You mean paying off a mortgage, paying it off prematurely, paying it off early? What? I'm not sure what you meant by it. Can you help me out?
I believe when you the longer you stay in a home, you got to make payments monthly to live in it.
Right. But what does that have to do with paying down a mortgage? You must have brought that up for a reason. Can you help me?
I'm honestly out of blank here.
Well, you brought it up, sir. I mean, you know, okay. Off the role play. Turn it around on him. Sir, what did you mean by that? I'm not sure if I quite understand. Can you help me out a little bit? You said paying down, and you said I don't understand. I understand a lot of terms. I just didn't understand what you meant by it. Can you elaborate a little bit?
Oh, are we still in the role play?
Oh, yeah. You see what I'm doing? Do you see what I'm doing sometimes?
Yeah. Pattern interrupts and
I embarrass the shit. Redirection. Yeah. I embarrass myself all the time. I don't know every answer to every question and every nuance. And I've been doing this a real long time. Every now and then somebody brings up something new. Gee, could you help me out? I'm not sure if I understand what you mean by that. Is that a stroke, by the way?
It could be, I believe.
Yeah.
Usually stroke would be mostly a compliment, right?
It's a compliment, but I'm praising you while putting myself down on purpose. Not sure if I understand, sir. Can you help me? Maybe I took a stupid pill this morning. I mixed it up with my vitamins. I don't know.
It's all right, Claude. We all have those days.
Oh, I have too many of them, you know, and everything. And you're obviously well-versed in real estate. I respect that. I could probably learn a lot from a guy like you. So thank you for bringing that up. So why is that important in this particular sequence? See, everything you throw at me, I throw back, and I get you to give me more information or make a commitment or explain to me, tell me how to sell you. This is the art and science of question-based redirection. How powerful is this? How powerful is this? How you just see, most people sell, it's Q&A, isn't it?
Usually, yeah.
Well, I'm going to ask you some questions. They ask questions. You're submissive and subservient, not acting confident. You're just being a little chihuahua begging at the table during steak night, okay? Okay, what's going on with their head? When they're asking questions, they're bullying you. They're picking your brain for free. We call that free consulting. And they're giving you all, and they're getting all that information from you. And then what's going through their head? Who's the jefe? Who's the boss there?
The prospect.
Yes. Do you want a doctor? Hey, doctor, write me out a prescription for some Oxycontin. I'm meeting some college buddies this week, and I want to get a buzz on. Okay, just write it up.
I would, Claude, but, you know, there's something called a law. And
come on. No big deal. Just write it. Okay, see, you are assertive, and you stood behind your license and your professionality. If you were and I'm sure there are doctors, unfortunately, like that out there. But so in sales, if I let the prospect manipulate me, pick my brain, ask a million questions, and then dismiss me, I'll think about it. I'll talk to my chihuahua, Pepe, later today about this. I'll call you in the near distant future. They're totally in control. They have no regard or respect for you, and they're dismissive of you. In guts, I want to get information and then utilize it to have them paint themselves in a corner and then close them. For instance, before I said, so, sir, if you could find somebody who wanted to buy your home today for either price or term so that you could move to your new home and this problem was off your back, that isn't a decision you could make today, is it?
It'd be a great decision to make today.
Which means? Could we move forward if I can solve your problem right now and make you an offer?
That's a good idea. I would be willing to work with you.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate your trust. I need a little bit more information. Can I ask you 2-3 quick questions? You ask me a few. We'll decide if we're comfortable with each other. I'll make you two or three. I'll send you a letter of intent with 3 different offers. And then you and I will talk tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock on Zoom, and we can either move forward or say it's over. Is that fair?
Yeah, that sounds fair.
I like doing business with you, sir. Thank you. Boom. Commitment, information, another appointment, all in one phone call.
Maybe 3 minutes or less.
Maybe in three. It's amazing what you can do in 3 minutes or less. It's being a wordsmith. It's putting together the psychology, the hypnotic effect of asking words the right way with the right nuances, and then combining it with a little bit of thespian skill. And that makes you a very dangerous person.
Right.
What did we learn today? Again, what did we learn today? 2 sessions today in one day. Woo! What did we learn today?
Pattern interrupts, negative redirections. Sales is very dangerous.
Yeah.
And
for them, not for you. For you, it's wonderful because it gives you access to unlimited income. If you have a good product or service like real estate, and you know how to have enough good every day, if you could have 2-3 conversations like we just did in role play, what do you think would be the result of that at the end of a couple days, a week or two?
Some improvements, I believe, in my...
You would be going to the Kim National Bank.
Oh, going to the bank.
Exactly. This is a good video. Can I use this video?
Sure. On YouTube.
Thank you. Thank you. So did I answer your question, your original question?
Yeah, you did.
Okay. You want to do one more role play, or you want to call it a day?
I think I'm good for now.
Okay. Good. So the thing is to sometimes say, why are we talking? What would you like to see happen? What was the point of this conversation? A little redirection. Oh, keep the house or keep renting or keep living in your mother's attic. It's low rent. You don't need a house right now. And make them justify their need, their greed, their pain, their problem. And then you go to them and say, if we could solve that problem that meets with your time frame, your budget, your needs, what would you do next? Now, boom, then you get a commitment. Then you go further into qualification. And then you go into, again, commitment to close. And you can close somebody on a million-dollar home, multi-million-dollar home in one phone call.
That's a good chunk of cash.
This is the different. This is how you become a one percenter. You can do all the guru bullshit and buy the applications and hire people, which is nonsense, and keep buying things and buy your ClickFunnel and buy your FreedomSoft software and do all your research and running around and everything. But why are we in business?
To make money today.
Amen, brother. Amen. Nice going, man. Good session. You like these? Is this the way to learn?
Yeah.
This is the way to learn. It's a little bit different than what you're used to, probably.
Yeah, I guess so. it's like a classroom setting before.
This is role playing with logical, explanation. And I'm not here to embarrass you or put you on the hot seat or make you. I'm here to teach you. I want to see you learn. My only mission is so that you make money and you say, wow, that was good value.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Good.